नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टैंडर्ड 9th सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 2nd इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सेपरेशन ऑफ इमिसिबल लिक्विड्स। सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय इमिसिबल लिक्विड्स? What is immiscible? See, here I have written the liquid which do not mix with one another. The liquid which do not mix with one another is called as immiscible liquids. For example, water and oil. Water or any oil. So that is an example of immiscible liquids. So you see the textbook, some of the example is given. Take a separating funnel. See, this one is a separating funnel. This instrument or this device is called as separating funnel. Or pour the mixture of kerosene oil and water. So here what will be there? Kerosene oil. And here what will be there? Water. Pour the mixture here. Both will be there here. Pour the mixture of kerosene oil and water. In the separating funnel, let it stand undisturbed for some time. So let it be for some time, you have to keep as it is. Now what you will see that? So that the separate layers of oil and water, see how we are seeing here separate layers. So these are the layers. Water and oil layer you are observing. Okay. And then what you have to do, open the stopcock. So this is the stopcock, just open it and of the separating funnel and pour out the lower layer of the water carefully. So here you have to collect the water, okay, which is lower. So then you have to open it and you have to collect. And close the stopcock again, separating the funnel as the oil reaches. When the oil reaches here, you have to close the stopcock. So, this is the principle. This is the way we can separate the immiscible liquids which have their different densities because of their different densities. See, water and kerosene oil, they have the different densities. So, the principle is that immiscible liquids separate out in the layers depending on their densities. Okay, now what is the application of this? What is the application? Or you are saying advantages of this. What is the application? The application is to separate the mixture of oil and water. So first one is to separate mixture of oil and water. So this one. And second application is in the extraction of iron from its ore. See, in the extraction of iron from its ore, Okay, these two are the in the extraction, taking off iron from its ore. Ore means mineral. From the mineral, iron you have to take out. So this is the, and here this one, the light slag is removed from the top by this, the waste of this lighter materials by this method to leave the molten iron at the bottom of the, molten iron is at the top, at the furnace, and the slag is at the top. In this way you can separate out. Okay, students. Now, how can we separate a mixture of camphor and salt? See, how will you separate the camphor? Camphor means kapoor, or you can say that naphthalene balls, phenyl guli, and salt. So, how we can separate? So, dear students, okay, first we will see that substances which changes directly from solid to the gaseous state on heating is called as sublimate substance, and the process is known as sublimation. See, now here you see this is the camphor is a sublimate substance. So on heating, it changes directly from solid to the gaseous state. So without going for liquid state, directly changes into the solid state. It is called as sublimate substance. So in this way, sublimate substances can be separated by this type of methods. See the here, separation of camphor and salt by the sublimation. Here what will be there? See, understand the diagram. So here a funnel will be there, and this is a China dish. China dish means that is a device, or you can say the vessel. When you heat it strongly, it will not break. That's why we are taking the China dish. Okay? And China dish, what will be there? Mixture of camphor and salt will be there. So after heating, see vapors, camphor changes into vapor form. And here some cooling will be there. Here it is solid fire camphor. Here after cooling here, it becomes as a solid. So vapor changes into solid without changing the liquid form. Okay. And this one is cotton flood because here the smoke, or you are saying the, which one? The, it should not go out. The fumes, no? The vapor not to go out. So that's why here cotton flood. And this one is inverted funnel. Okay. So this can separate the camphor and salt. And the process is called as sublimation. See, some examples of solid with sublimate substances are ammonium chloride. See, some of the examples, ammonium chloride. So this is an example of sublimate substance. And also naphthalene balls, naphthalene, NaPhTHA, naphthalene, and also one more, anthracene. So what will be that? Anthracene, ENTHRA. So these are the example of sublimate substances. Camphor, ammonium chloride, naphthalene, and anthracene. So these are the examples of which one? Sublimate substance. In this way, by using this method of sublimation process, we can separate the sublimate substance. Okay, students, what are the ideas now? Now, how can we separate a mixture of two miscible liquids? Miscible. So, miscible means what? The liquid which mix with one another is called as miscible liquids. The liquid which mix with one another is called as miscible liquids. Example, water and milk, acetone and water. So these are other examples of miscible liquids. So very important question, dear students. So how you can separate this? See, take the mixture of acetone and water. Here we have taken the acetone and water. In this mixture we have taken. This is the flask, distillation flask. What you are saying? Distillation flask. And fit with your thermometer. And this is the condenser. Okay. Then this one is water drawer, water outlet. And this one is a beaker. Okay, like this arrangement we have to do. Heat the mixture slowly, keeping a close watch with the thermometer. Very close watch with the thermometer. Closely you have to observe it. The acetone vaporizer. See, try to understand now. The acetone is here, the mixture, acetone and water will be there. The acetone vaporizers condenses in the condenser and can be collected from the condenser outlet. See, when acetone vaporizes, goes to this, and then here condenser, this is vapor form, then cooling here, then it becomes acetone. So in this way, you can separate acetone and water will be here only. Okay? So water is left behind the distillation flask. So dear students, the method is here. This method is called as distillation process. It is used for the separation of the components of the mixture containing two miscible liquids. The liquids mix with one another. Okay, without going for any decomposition, any separate parts will not have been formed. And this one is used for sufficient differences in their boiling points. See, this acetone and water, their boiling points are differences. Whenever any liquids or two or three liquids, any mixture is given to you, so this method can be, or distillation method is very useful for separating the miscible liquids. Okay, now one more point we are discussing to separate the mixture of the miscible liquids with the difference in their boiling points is less than 25 Kelvin. So this you know that what do you mean by the Kelvin? Okay, that is the heat measurement. See, suppose the difference between the two or three miscible liquids, the difference is 25 Kelvin, then the fractional distillation process will be used. What will be that? Fractional distillation. See, this method will be used for separating this. So here, this is, for example, you have to separate from the different gases from the air. See, from different gases from air, and then the different fractions of petroleum, different fractions from the petroleum products. See, different fractions from petroleum products. So the fractional distillation methods are using. And what is the difference between the distillation and fractional distillation? The apparatus is similar to that simple distillation. What is the simple distillation? The same way, but here except that fractionating column will be there. So in between the condenser and as well as distillation plus, so there is a, what will be there? Fractionating column is fitted. So this one, only the difference will be there. Okay, distillation between the distillation plus and the condenser. Okay, got the idea now? Whenever two or more miscible liquids, that difference is 25 Kelvin, then the fractional distillation methods are using. For example, different gases from the air and different fractions from the petroleum. So these will be used. And here what will be there? A simple fractionating column is a tube packed with the glass beads. This beads provides a surface for the vapors to cool. And here, this bead will be there. And that is giving, what you are saying? The surface for the vapors to cool and condense. Condense means making cooler repeatedly. So in this way, the miscible liquids can be separated. Okay, that you are saying fractional distillations. So dear students, today we have learned how can we separate the mixture of two immiscible liquids, and how can we separate a mixture of salt and camphor, and then one is how can we separate a mixture of two miscible liquids, and how can we separate of two or three miscible liquids, their temperature is difference is between 25 Kelvin. Okay students, go through it and read properly, try to understand the process. Okay. Bye bye.
Thank you for joining us.